Society. This chapter covers that period. The New Dynasty. Duke William, when he was crowned King of England on Christmas Day 1066, stressed that he was the designated heir of Edward the Confessor. That he was so designated cannot be proved, though several chosen successor. Those present at Westminster would have been less worried about the title than about the content of William's kingship. He promised that every man should have the protection of his own law, a law which varied according to his rank and the part of England in which he lived, and that every man should be his father's heir, which meant of property would be respected. To the Londoners, to whom he looked for popular recognition of his kingship and practical help, he repeated these promises in a surviving writ, which is right here. This is the writ of William I in favour of the city of London, 1067. His men of London, both French and English, frontlies the use of English, and what is said in the text is intended to emphasise the continuity of William's kingship. So the surviving Christmas Day. discussion with his council about this country, how it was occupied, or with what sort of people. The inquiry that followed had two major aims: to investigate the resources first of the king, and then of his most important subjects. Such information was always useful, but particularly so in 1085, when the king had been expecting an invasion from Denmark and had quartered a huge army on his vassals in England, each according to their means. The costs of such an operation may have prompted a desire on William's part to know exactly what he was entitled to expect and how much land distributed to his vassals. So here is Domesday Book, two volumes of Domesday Book on the chest in which they were kept during the 17th and 18th centuries. They have been rebound on several occasions. Domesday first taken ill in France, the professor Saints in the Middle Ages developed complicated legends, the need
Thank you.
Chester Castle. Let's read a bit about this. Like London and Canterbury, Rochester in 1066 was a Saxon cathedral city within Roman walls. At a river crossing, using the ancient defences, the Normans promptly gave all three towns a new style. Chester Castle, the Great Hall. Stirling Castle was the only major fortress held against Robert, and it was due to surrender, if not relieved, before Midsummer 1314. When Robert made that agreement, he possibly calculated that domestic political problems would continue to prevent Edward II from making a major effort in Scotland. In the event, Edward led some 2,000 to 3,000 cavalry and around 20,000 infantry north in June 1314. And this picture is King Robert about to kill Sir Henry de Bohun. And Bower's impression of the Scottish weapons and formation is probably reliable. Whispers.